Hi everyone, I'm Gina from Gina K Designs and your host of Stamp TV. Today on Stamp TV, I'm going to show you how I color with colored pencils and Gamsol. I've gotten a lot of requests lately to show this technique, so I'm going to show you my way of doing it. Let me show you the tools and products you need to make this card project. First, you're going to need some stamps, and the stamps that I am going to use today are the brand new stamps from the Another Name for Love stamp set. Now, this is a brand new collaboration stamp set that I did with Unity Stamp Company. And I just love the whole concept of this set. Angela and I had talked about it, and she said, let's do something for moms and for Mother's Day and just for mothers in general. So that's what all of these greetings are about. And it's just such a nice set, whether you're sending your mom a birthday card or a Mother's Day card. The greetings are very heartfelt. I'm going to use the large flower stamp for my coloring technique, and this is a really big, bold stamp and perfect for coloring. Then for ink, I'm going to use the Memento Tuxedo Black ink. If you don't have this ink, you can also use Stazon ink or any other type of ink that won't run when you hit it with the Gamsol. So I tend to either use Memento or Stazon. Then, in this little jar, I have some Gamsol, and this is how I keep my Gamsol. Let me show you what the big bottle looks like. This is the big bottle that we have in our retail store because we teach colored pencil classes there. So I just pour a little bit of this into my jar with the lid, and this just helps me carry it around, and I'm able to use it at home or back in my office, wherever I want. I also have a blending stump. And then I have one of these little sandpaper things. And this comes in a set by Inky Antics. And you get blending stumps, you get a little bit of Gamsol, and then you get this sandpaper. And this sandpaper is great for filing off the color. Once you've used your blending stump, it removes any of the color from the last color that you used, and it cleans up your stump. It also helps you get it to a nice fine point. So for colored pencil colors, for my card that I'm going to do first, I'm going to use aquamarine, I'm going to use Prussian green, and I'm going to use artichoke. Of course, you can use any colored pencils you want, and you can use any colors you want, depending on what color cardstock you're going to use. Now, I have a piece of our Artist's Choice cardstock. I want to show you what that looks like. This is the big pack. And this is a special type of cardstock that we've come up with that's perfect for colored pencils. It's really super smooth, but it has a little bit of a tooth to it, so it will grab the colored pencil just a little bit better. You can also use this for Copics or other alcohol markers, and it's a really nice cardstock. It's 110 pounds, and it's very thick and rigid, so you can use it as a card base as well if you want to do a single layer card, but it will bleed through if you use Copics or other alcohol markers. So if you want to do a single layer card with those types of coloring tools, you should use our heavy base weight pure luxury white cardstock. So this is what I'm using today. And then I also have a little washi tape here, and I have a new set of dies I want to show you. These are by Cheerylynn Designs, and these are called the Curved Border Set. And I want to show you how I use these dies. This is a really fun set. It's got a die that is just the blade, just the actual shape, and then it's got different types of things that you can put over it, like big dots, little dots, and stitches. So I'm going to show you how I use that in some of my card projects. I also am using the EyePoint Orbit Pencil Sharpener, and I will link all of these items below the screen so you can find them easily. And I have my big pencil case here. You can see all my pencils are in here. This has four different zippers, and each zipper opens up like this and is filled with colored pencils. And this is how I carry around my Prismacolor pencils. And I will link this too in case you're interested in that. All right, so let me show you how I color. So, and for Unity stamps, these are the cling stamps. So they've got this cling cushion on the back and they'll just cling to your block. And I use the Gina K Designs binder sheets to store them on. And then I like to either keep them in the bag or I'll use one of our binder boxes for them. But when I'm doing videos, I like to keep them in the bag so I can bring the whole set out and show you. Okay, so what I'm going to do first is, I have some dust here from sanding my blending stump. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to stamp this image using some of the Memento Tuxedo Black ink. So when it's a big stamp like this, I like to turn it on its back and ink it up really well so I can see that it's real inky. All right, and this I'm just going to stamp off of my card like that. And you can see how nice that image is. It's a delicate image, but it's nice and big, so it makes it's really nice for coloring. All right, so I'm going to begin by using my aquamarine pencil. And what I'm going to do is, you'll notice in this flower, there are a lot of little sketchy lines. I'm going to color over those sketchy lines using my aquamarine pencil, just like that. And that's all I'm going to color. I'm not going to color anywhere else. I'm not going to add a second color at all. And this is just a fun technique to do if you don't want to have to think a lot about what colors to blend together and you're really just looking for some pretty shading. So you can see I'm coloring all along those lines. And what's nice is this image kind of helps you see where to color because the lines are already drawn in where the color should be darker. So this is a very helpful stamp to start with if you're just beginning with colored pencil. Or if you're an expert, then you already probably know where to color. I'm not an expert. I don't claim to be one, but I do have a lot of fun with colored pencils. I have to say, they have become one of my new favorite ways to color. And I think it's just because I feel like I have a lot of control with a colored pencil. It doesn't move unless you want it to move. So if you color in one little spot, that's the spot where the color is going to be, where markers kind of spread out a little bit. Plus, if you use a technique like the Gamsol, or you use a technique like the heavy to light shading, you really only need one pencil to create a lot of depth and a lot of shading. And you don't really need to know how to, you know, mix colors together and stuff. So it's a real nice, easy beginner way to color. Plus, it's just so fun and it's easy to take with you. Okay, so you can see I've colored all along the bottoms of each of these petals. Now for this bud here, I'm just going to color in those lines as well. I'm going to color a little bit on top here, like that. All right, so that's for my flower. Now I have my jar of Gamsol here. I'm just going to open that jar up. And then when you're using a brand new blending stump, I highly recommend that you sand it first. That makes it a little more porous and it will allow the Gamsol to get sucked up into it. Otherwise, it takes longer for the Gamsol to absorb into the blending stump and you may not have enough on there to do what you want to do. So I'm just going to place my blending stump into the Gamsol and you can see that it's getting sucked right up into that blending stump. And then I'm going to start right on top of my aquamarine color. And using a circular motion, I'm just going to move that pencil up just a little bit, like that. And you can see as I get closer to the top, it's getting lighter as I go. I'm just going over those dark areas and then just dragging that color up. And you can see now it's starting to look more shaded and not just like a line of colored pencil. So I'm kind of working my way up to the top, and as I get to the top of each of those flower petals, it gets lighter and lighter. And if you have some areas that almost look white, just leave them. In nature, everything isn't exactly the same. There's a lot of, you know, variance in color, and that's what makes it so pretty. So you can see, just using that Gamsol and just blending that out. super easy to do. And you really don't have to be very skilled at all. I know you can do it. So you can see how quick and easy. I mean, it's fast, too. It's not like you have to think a whole lot. That's another thing I like about it. Not a lot of thinking, not a lot of planning. Looks like I missed one there. I'll have to add a little bit more pencil there. And by filing the blending stump first, you can see I have enough Gamsol in there that I'm really kind of going a long way here without resaturating my blending stump. That was a lot of petals I did. Just a little bit more here in the center. And then you can see I missed that one. So let me go back and add just a little bit of color in there. And if you want to, if you want to branch out past this, you can go back along the bottom with a darker turquoise and add some darker shading and then just kind of soften it with the Gamsol. But really, you don't need to do much more than that. All right, so I'm going to work my way down around this bud. And you can see I'm going to leave some white in there like that. And that's kind of just, you know, it may not be correct as far as what an artist would do and where the light's coming from and all of that. But to me, it looks pretty. And that's my whole goal, is just to make a card that looks pretty. So now I'm going to add some green. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to go down like that, just on the one side. So I'm coloring in the center, and then I'm just coming down a little bit down the one side there. And this one, I'll go heavy along all these lines. So you can see I'm not really adding a ton of color, just a little bit that I can blend out with the Gamsol. I'll go along the little the veins here in the leaves. Okay, and then a little bit here down the stems. And I'll just soften that with the Gamsol. Now I'm going to file, I'm going to use the opposite side. I don't like to file my blending stump while it's still wet. So I'm going to use the other side and just file that off a little bit because there was a little color left from what I was playing with last night. And I'm going to wet that, and now I'm going to blend out these leaves. You can see how that just moves that green into a lighter green off to the side there where I didn't color. And then down here I'm doing the same thing, just little circular motions just to bring that color out. Leaving a little bit of white in the center there. This is a big leaf. So I'll work that color. You can see where I colored over the veins. That's a little darker. And I'll just bring that over a bit. And I'm not going to leave that all white. I'm actually going to add a second pencil color in here. Just because it's very green, and I really want to kind of add a little bit of a yellow or a brown, so that's where this artichoke is going to come in, and I'm just going to lightly shade in those areas that are more white. Just add a little bit of that in there. You can see how that kind of softens it and gives it a little more depth. And I'll add a little on these little tiny ones here. And I'm not even going to blend that out. I'm just going to, I just colored so lightly that it really doesn't need too much blending. So that's how easy it is to color this beautiful flower, this new Unity Stamp Company stamp. We do have this one now available at GinaKDesigns.com, and it's in the What's New category. So if you're interested in it, you can take a look there, or if you have some other Unity stamps you want to buy, you can check out UnityStampCo.com, and you can get it over there. Now, my next thing I want to show you is I want to show you how this new die set works. So let me grab my Cuddlebug here. I think I'm just going to cut a little bit off of one side of this image. Okay, so I'm going to get my C plate here, and I'm just going to turn it sideways like this. And I'm doing that because I'm just going to cut a little bit off of this side here. And what you're going to do is you're going to find the blade, the die that's just the plain blade. And I'm going to line this up along the edge of my card, and I just want to make sure that it looks fairly even on either side. So I'm kind of hitting those arcs in the same spot. And then I have a little bit of washi tape here, and I'm going to place the washi tape right on the die and right on the piece of cardstock that I'm cutting off. And then I'm going to do the same thing again with another little piece on this side. Make sure that's about the same. It's going to cut the same, kind of like check that spot and make sure that it's fairly even. Okay. And the reason why I had you turn it this way is because it's a lot easier to see. And once you get your washi tape on there, then you can feed it into your Cuddlebug. I'm going to put that B plate on top. And I'm going to cut that. And you can see what that looks like. Isn't that a pretty edge? Now, you can save this piece. So you can do something fun, like take a piece of black cardstock and put one end on the card like that, and then space it just a little bit and have a nice little delicate design in there if you like that split look. Or you can save that for another card, put it along the top of something or down the side, and just use the one piece. Or you can do like I did here, and I really spaced them far apart to make an interesting edge. Okay, so now we're going to add a decorative edge. So there's three to choose from. There's this tiny little dotted one. There is this stitched one, which is very popular right now. And if you use a lot of stitched dies, this is a nice one to use to coordinate. And then there's one that actually does little holes, and that's fun too. So I think I'm going to use the stitched one for this, since that's probably the most commonly used one among card makers. But they're all so cute. Okay, so what you want to do with this is you just want to put that right up to the edge. Like that. And then take that washi tape. Once you get it in position, tape it down. And tape it down. You can look at it, make sure it looks pretty straight. If it doesn't, just shift it a little bit. And that looks pretty good. And now I'm going to turn it and put it back into my machine. Put that plate on top, and now I'm going to press in that stitching. Show you what that looks like. Let me gently peel this up. Washi tape's great to use because it doesn't really damage the cardstock at all. So now you can see that this has a cute little stitched edge all along there. Can you see that? Isn't that sweet? That's so sweet. And so that could be used for your card. So that is a fun little die set to use, and that is now available as well at Gina K Designs. Now I want to show you a finished card that I did using that die and the flower that we just colored. And instead of using the stitched one, on this one you can see I used the tiny little dotted line. If you're having trouble seeing that, at stamptv.com, underneath the video, I will have photographs of these cards so you can see the edges a little bit cleaner. So that's one way to use it. And this combination is that same aquamarine pencil that I used. And it looks really nice with our Turquoise Sea cardstock. So now I want to show you another one that I did. And instead of doing the cut edge on the side, I did it at the bottom. And I did this one in purple. And you can see I did the stitched edge because I used some rectangle stitch dies. And these are the Cottage Cutz stitch dies, and they're available at Gina K Designs as well. So there are two ways to use that fancy die. And then I wanted to show you one more color combination. I had made one using powder blue. And this one is a more traditional card, doesn't use any of the fancy edges like the other two do. But I thought that was so nice. And I love this greeting, "A mother understands what her child does not say." And this one, "My mother, my friend." And this one, "Mother is another name for love." So those are three different cards that I made using this new stamp set, "Another Name for Love," and some of these fun dies. I want to show you one more thing. If you happen to have a big die cutting machine, some of you have the Cheerylynn Big Sister, or you have the Crossover, one of those really big machines, then you can actually use the die going into your machine in this orientation. And if you do, then you can do something fun like this. I actually did the edge of one of the envelopes, and I thought that was kind of a fun thing to do. I cut the edge, and I also used the stitch die. The only problem with doing it in a smaller machine is the envelope, it's too big, so it doesn't fit through the machine this way, and if you keep the envelope closed, then you will cut into the envelope as well. So I had a little bit of trouble. There's probably little plates and things that you can insert under here to make sure that it doesn't cut through. And I'll play around with a few things. I tried folding it under my B plate, kind of like this. But then it did put a little edge in the envelope here and a little edge in the envelope here. So that might, I mean, if that doesn't bother you, you can certainly just fold it over the edge of your B plate and then line up your die and send it through. And that will work. But you might have to deal with just a little, it's just a little line that you get right here. Not a real big problem, but it does happen. Okay, so those are some of my finished card projects, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Which color combination do you like best, or do you like them all? Let me know in the comments below. I love to hear what you guys think. So thank you so much for watching today's Stamp TV video, and stop back soon for more Stamp TV videos featuring the new Bold and Blooming Stamp TV kit. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.